Well, hello, time now for some mom hacks. What can you do at your home with your toddler that's fun and educational at the same time?
Karen and I got some great ideas from blogger Callie Brancefort. Maybe they can help you out. Take a look.
Hi, Callie. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
All right, so a lot of parents are home with their kids, homeschooling or distance learning.
Yeah, and the older kids, you know, they get the assignments from school, so that's a little easier. But what are you supposed to do with your toddler? You have some ideas.
I do. I put together a couple activities that are specifically good for listening skills. The good thing about toddlers is a lot of their learning happens through play. So we don't have to like worry too much about as parents, like, are we teaching our kids? But I do have some little activities that'll help just in general with language and listening skills. And so my first one is to use matching as an activity. Matching is really great because it's building memory and cognitive skills, but as well as direction following. And the options are like literally endless when it comes to matching. You can have kids help you match socks when you're putting away your laundry. You can have them match stuffed animals to animals in a book. One little activity I've made is I literally have just cut up pieces of construction paper in large colors. And then I have matching ones in little colors. And my son loves to match the little squares to the big squares. Oh. It's just a really little thing. Great for listening skills. And like I said, again, it was great for just like basic direction following.
Yeah, my parents used to do that with playing cards. It was called concentration. And you'd have to match the different spade or club.
Like put
or
spades with spades?
Spades with spades or the number with the number. And it was very cool. And with a simple deck of cards.
Yeah, any of that. Yeah, that's really
good. There's literally endless options, and that's why I love it.
Okay, stuffed animal conversation. I'm imagining tea party and talking to the bear. What do you mean?
Yeah, that's actually sort of what I mean, but just being a little bit more intentional about it. I know it feels like, again, like play, but at this age, it's so good for their listening and their language. So what I like to do is I'll give my son like a dollar stuffed animal, and I'll usually take one too. And then what I'm going to do is sort of like imitate play, things that I would do with him. So I'm going to hold the doll, talk to the doll, dress it or feed it, sort of the way that I would do with him, and then encourage him to do the same. And it's just a great way to help with their listening, but it also really helps to build language a lot. And again, it's one of those things that feels like play, but you're developing those really great skills that our toddlers need.
Shapes on the floor game?
Yeah. I like this because it brings a little bit of gross motor in, especially if your kids are getting, you know, they're sort of cooped up. I do it on my front porch, just use some painter's tape. You're going to make out a couple of shapes. If your kids are sort of new with shapes, start with like two, you know, a circle and a square. And then you're going to call out the shape's name and your kid can run and jump into the shape. You could use beanbags and throw a beanbag into the shape. But it's really good, again, for following direction and for listening. And then you can sort of build up as well as your kids get used to it. You can add a couple more shapes. But I just like it because it combines language with gross motor skills.
Oh, very interesting.
Yeah, that's great. Get out the old twister, too. That's always fun.
I was just thinking the same thing. I love twister.
That one works, too.
Then we get to play. All right, tunnel pass. What's that?
Yeah, I love this game. So you're going to need a pop-up tunnel. A lot of parents have these lying around. They're really not that expensive to buy. And then a couple of balls. You have to model this for your toddler the first few times, but you're going to put a ball inside of the tunnel, and you're going to lift the tunnel up so the ball will fall through. And again, your child might want to watch you a few times before they do it. But then they're going to catch right on and they love it. My son loves this game. He loves trying different balls. He likes trying different toys to see what toy will go down the tunnel. But what I really like about it is not only does it require a little bit of direction following, but it's a good teamwork building thing, which is really good at this age because you kind of are taking turns on either side of the tunnel. So it's just like a different way to use one of those pop-up tunnels that you probably have laying around to sort of build some listening and some direction following.
I think I use that for my cat.
I was going to say, I have cat tunnels. I think we have bigger ones for the kids.
All right. And washing animals.
Yeah. So this is one that sort of a lot of people have done like sink play with their kids or water play with their kids because it's a good sensory activity. And kids love to do it. What I do is just get a Tupperware, a water table, a sink, fill it with some soapy water, and then give your kids some different like farm animals, whatever plastic animals you have laying around, and some stuff to clean them with, like a cloth or a sponge. Kids will naturally really like to do this because it's something that they watch you do. It's like an every activity they love watching you do. And a really easy way to bring some language into this is just take it as an opportunity to talk to your animals, you're not talking to your animals, you're talking to your kids about the different animals. So you could talk about their names, talk about the different sounds they make. If your kid's a little older, you can talk about where they live. It's just a really fun way, again, to pair like a fine motor sensory activity and bring in some language and listening to it.
I don't know, Callie, when you live alone with your cat, you talk to the animals.
I also talk to the animals.
All right. Thank you so much, Callie. Great for keeping those toddlers occupied. And for more great tips, people can always visit your blog at it's at First Coffee.
But First Coffee.
But First Coffee. I'm sorry. I'm saying that wrong. ButFirstCoffee.com.
Thanks, Callie. We appreciate it. Have a great day.
You too. Thanks.
That's why we gave Kara the day off today. It's ButFirstCoffeeBlog.com.
I think I read it as But First Coffee.
blog.com.
Who knows?
All right. So we, you know, Irene and I were talking about, you know, visiting downtown Hartford, visiting downtown New Haven, supporting some of those local restaurants because they really are struggling. I went to Peppercorn's the other night.
Yes.
Saw Dino, great guy.
Fantastic
the food was
restaurant.
Great. There were people there. Yeah. It was nice to see that. So if you can, you know, think about going out and supporting some local restaurants.
Yeah, some of these local
places. I know
places,
some of you might be hesitant, but.
You know, Salute in Hartford. You know, the problem is.
Fang
in Hartford, great sushi there. Great places in New Haven. The problem is everybody's been working from home, not going into the office. So a lot of these restaurants are really struggling and they could use your help if you're looking for something to do with the kids. A lot of them have great social distancing in there. They've made sure everything's ventilated so it's safe to go.
You done talking?
So yeah, I think I'm done
macaroni.
Now.
Macaroni. All right, that's it for Medicine. Thank you for being with me.
Thanks for having me.
Take care. We'll see you. Eyewitness News at 4 is next.